Grab your teammate and pack your bags, cause we're going to Team League. Stand up! Bangados! Hey Carfighters, today I don't have a new card reveal that is of big significance, but I have something else that is very exciting to announce, and that is that Bushiroad officially announced that next year, in Springfest, it will be another year of Team League. So for those who don't know what Team League is, it's basically you and two friends are going to form a team, and you're going to face off against other teams that are also going to the same competition. And how it works is it's basically the same as your normal Swiss in your normal tournament, that you only play one round, but this time you play one round, each player from your team, against the other players of each team. So you're facing off against opponents, your teammates facing off against another of that team, and the other player from your team is going to face up against the last person of their team. And each player is going to play one match against them at the same time, and the team with the most wins is going to win that round. So if you have two of the three matches won in your team, you get the victory point for that round. And that is going to happen for the rounds that you're going to play. So 7, 6, 8, depending on how big your tournament is. And then at the end of that, you have your generic top 8 that works the same way. So in a sense, it's the best of three format that you're going to play three matches in the entirety of your team. But as a player, you're going to play a single round. And what's awesome about this tournament is that although it still promotes competition, it's a lot more on the casual side, as seen as you're going with friends, you're having a lot of fun, you're going with a group, and you're also playing against other people that are just in it here to mostly have fun. As seen as last year when I made it even to the top cut in the tournament, it was still, everybody's very friendly, very happy and open about it and really relaxed, and it wasn't really that much of a tension that you usually have when you're going in a single player tournament. As seen as you're the only one playing and everything is on the line about you. And that's also something that is very awesome with Team League, is that you're going with a team and you can support each other. You're going as a combined, you're doing it as a combined effort. And if you lose a match or something goes wrong, you can still rely on your teammates to basically pick you up and carry you for that match, and the next round you can do it for them. And that is an amazing feeling to have that connection with your teammates. And if you can have that good bonds with them, I can assure you that it's probably going to be one of your most memorable matches and your memorable days playing Vanguard, as it is the most fun and exciting thing to do. And this year Team League is going to be even bigger than last year, as soon as we're going to have one for Standard, and we're going to have one for Premium. So we have two different Team Leagues for Card Fight Vanguard. Also they have one for White Swords and Buddy Fight, but we are a Vanguard channel, so we're mainly going to focus only on those two. So you can have a choice of going to either one of them if you're only interested in one is a format of the game. But you can also, like I'm probably going to do, go to both if that's possible, if they're held in a different time or a different day of each other. And like any Bushiroad Championship series, it's going to be divided in two circuits. We have the Shop Challenge circuit and we have the Official Championship circuit. In last competition, you could win a buy card if you won your shop tournament, and you could have a free win for the first one or two rounds. In Team League, this works a little bit different. Instead of only the number one player wins a specific card, it's the top three players that get a special promotion gift card. And what you can do with that gift card is go to the tournament and then exchange that for basically a new special kind of card. In Buddy Fight and White Swords, it's a hot stamp version of the promo that you're going to get when you're entering the Shop Challenge tournament. For Vanguard, it's a little bit different, because you're going to get a special version of a gift marker, as seen as one of these, for example. And actually, these look very nice. Also, what's very interesting is that the fact that it's the promos you're going to get if you're entering the Shop Challenge. For Standard, that's going to be Sun Maiden's Sunlight Garden Guide, the Neo Nectar promo that you actually need to make the deck very strong. But also for those who've been bugging me on the videos quite some while, we finally now got a release for Bene GC for Murakumo, as that's going to be the promo for Premium if you enter their Shop Challenge. So go nuts. If you want any of these promos, then I highly recommend you to enter the Shop Challenge. For the Shop Challenge competition, you don't have to make a team. It's still a singles format. That's the reason that the top three players is going to get the gift card instead of only the number one, as seen as potentially can be the top three players. If we take a look back at OG Vanguard Animation, the very first season, they made their team with the top three players or the top four, because Q4 is the four players. That's basically what Bushiroad is encouraging. That the top three players of a local shop that won the Bikeart are trying to make their as a team and then go to the competition. It's not that it's probably going to happen, but maybe in your locals you can make it work. If nobody of your top three players have a team, then you can maybe form one. So take it with that. Now to the prizes for the official competition. Like last year, both versions for Standard to Premium will get some awesome entry prizes, but also amazing prizes when you make it to the top table. So let's go over the entry prizes first. So for Standard, we're going to get this Shadow Paladin playmat. That is, believe, Gus Bluster Dragon, or if I'm pronouncing the name correct. And we get a special promo that they aren't really that clear about it on the website. It looks about that it's going to be the same promo imaginary gift mark that you're going to get if you got the coupon by winning, getting first, second, or third place at the shop tuners. But I think there's going to be a little bit difference, maybe in hot stamp on it or a foil pattern. I don't know what the specifics about it is, but we're probably going to get more information down the line, and otherwise we'll have to see it when we go to the event themselves. But you will get some awesome gift markers and you will get this playmat. For premium, you're going to get this playmat with these three units on them, and you will get the same promotional gift marker with it. So these are your entry level participation prizes, and that's really awesome that you're going to get playmats by just entering the competition. I really like that you're going to give that these free stuff to players. As seen as currently there are nothing about deck boxes or anything, it's probably we're going to get them. Maybe we get them. I don't really mind if we're not getting them. I really dig it that we're going to get these playmats instead. But now let's go into the kicker. Let's see what we're going to get if we're going to top cut. Alright, on the official website, they only state they announce the playmat that you're going to get for top four. This is the one for standard, really nice. And this is the one for premium. And I know that a lot of people really like this. And I find it really ironically that they're going with this for premium, as seen as for some people it's an issue. But I really dig the designs of it, and they will look pretty awesome. How far? This is the only thing that has been confirmed as of yet. But from my experience, you're probably, if you're going to top 8, you get one of these. Usually they give these out for Team League. They have done it in the past, they have done it last year, and the years before that when they did it way back. So I am assuming you're going to get one of these medals if you're going to top 8. These are basically the pins that you can put up your basically on your clothes or something. They're really nice. So that's for top 8. You get top 4 again, you'll get the playmat. And if you're going to get past top 4, you're going to get a medal. A bronze medal for if you're third, a silver medal if you're second, and a first medal when you're first. And also you will get a special promotional hot stamp promo that isn't officially announced of yet. They only announced that there's going to be a victory promo, but not which card is going to be and how it's going to look like. Also, what you're going to get if you're going to the top 4, I believe, a position, you also get a certificate like this one that will basically state the tournament on them, the logo of this, which tournament ship you participated, your team name, and what position you run up. This one is for first runner-up, so second place. You see the location where I did it, in Belgium, regional championship, and was Spring Fest last year. So you'll get something like this when you get, I believe, 4th, 3rd, 2nd and 1st position. So if you're as excited as I am for some friendly and awesome competition and going out playing with your friends and against some other awesome Vanguard players, or you just want to go in and try to win all these awesome prizes that has already been revealed and has yet to be revealed, then I highly recommend you guys to pick up some teammates, pick up a deck, and prepare for next year, as seen as Bushiroad Spring Fest 2019 is coming at us on a high velocity speed. Because the first tournament is going to be planned between February and June. So expect them to hit the reveal date very soon. As of this day, when we're shooting this video, they haven't announced any locations or time dates, but I'm expecting them to, before the end of December, that the first ones are going to be revealed as time progresses. So stay tuned on their website. Link is on the screen here. Check that website out quite frequently to see any updates about your locations. And otherwise, I will wish you all the best of luck when you're going into these tournaments. And I hope you all have some amazing fun, as I did last year, and as I hope I'm going to have this year. And for those in Europe, maybe I will see you guys at one of these Team League. But as always, guys, I'm Mr. Time Leap, and I'll see you guys in the next one.